Hello friends, welcome to my another video tutorial on WordPress and WooCommerce for intermediate and advanced users. In this particular video tutorial, I will discuss about hooks. Basically, there are two types of hooks in WordPress, action hooks and filter hooks. But in this particular tutorial, I will be explaining more about action hooks rather than explaining filter hooks. Of course, in future, I will make another video tutorial on filter hooks as well. Before I go further and put more details about hooks, you should understand what is a hook. Basically, what is a hook? So in WordPress, hooks enable you to change how WordPress behaves without editing any core files. Because you leave the WordPress files untouched, you can painlessly upgrade your website with each new version of WordPress. It is this hooks architecture which makes WordPress the best blogging and website development solution. So, about action hooks, in WordPress there are three types of action hooks: add action, do action, and remove action. Add action hook will enable you to create your own hooks, or you can add your own functionality, or you can add an extra action to already existed action hook. Do action hook will perform the functionality which is added by add action hook. Remove action hook will remove the functionality added by add action hook. So let's get some live examples of action hooks and see it in action live. Fire up your favorite text editor. In this example, I'm using Sublime Text and I'm using 2017 child theme. If you don't know what is a child theme or how to create child theme, kindly view my previous tutorials. The links are given below in the description. So to understand add action, remove action and do action, I will be making some changes in functions.php file. At the end of this file, to perform a do action or perform a remove action, it must be added to the WordPress. So to add it into the WordPress, we first choose add action. As add action function accept four parameters. The last two mostly are unnecessary if you are creating, but sometime when already created function is using those two parameters, so you must consider them using. The number 10 represents the priority of the this action, and number 1 it returns true. This is the default, always default parameter, so you can safely remove it. So in add action, first we define a tag which will be used to perform do action function. So here I will type its name, my own action. Keep in mind that this name must be unique. If it isn't, it may override another action and malfunction or create a problem in your theme or a plugin. So make 100% sure you are using a unique name. Then this name doesn't exist anywhere in the WordPress world. Why I'm saying is WordPress world? Maybe any third party plugin, or maybe a plugin from repository, or maybe by WordPress, this function is added already. So make sure that this function does not, or this tag doesn't exist anywhere in the WordPress world. So function to add. This function which you will add here, you have to define it in the function.php or in your plugin. So my own action function. and priority is of course 10. So here I must define function, my own action function. So what I'm going to do in this function, simply echo something as a basic example, because I'm not going to explain all the actions or filters provided by WordPress. This is not the scope of this tutorial. It will just let you know that there are actions, there are filters which you can use to modify the functionality of the WordPress without modifying the core files. So here I will put echo hello world, simple as cucumber, cool as cucumber, sorry. Now what I have done, I didn't add my own action. So now I will save it, go to my browser, go to front end, and I will reload. And nothing's gonna happen. Wherever you go, nothing will happen. Why is nothing happening? Because we haven't used do action anywhere in the theme. Although we have created add action, but we haven't used it by using do action. So let's go to my admin panel, go to my child theme, as I want to override some files. So first I need to check which file I need to override. I want to display this hello world text after the title of each post on single post page. This is a single post. So how I know? Just in my introductory video tutorial, I have explained the plugin you need to install. One of them is what the file. What this plugin do, it will display which PHP file you need to modify to get your desired result. So here I'm talking about displaying hello world after the page title. So I will go to what the file, and it's telling me it's in the single, from the single.php. Still, if I go down, it says there are some template parts involved when after loading the single.php. So from here is header image, site branding, and content. So basically, I need to copy this content.php file as it is available on the parent theme. So in the parent theme, there is a template part folder. In that folder, there is a post folder. And in that particular folder, there is a content folder, well, content.php file. By using this plugin, child theme configurator, it makes lot easier for you to override the file. So just log into files, into your child theme configurator plugin dashboard, goes to files tab, find the content.php file. So here it is, content.php file. I will click here and then copy selected to child theme, and it will be added here. Click here, and as you can see, this is successfully added. Also, you can go to appearance editor, and you can find here, because this one is inherited and further it's added in the folder, so it will not be shown here in the list of your child theme. So to make it available here, you need to must using FTP or cPanel to access this file in child theme. So what I need to do is, after the title, this is the title, and there are two types of title, if it's single and else. So else mean it will be displayed any other place if this post is available, if it's not on the single page. So my task is to display it on the single post. So I will do action, and in this do action, I will need to add the tag name, which is the first, my own action. Control C, Control V, and save it. So as it is saved, now I will go into the front end and reload the single page and you will see on each and every single post you will have this hello world message. So now, as we have defined this add action here, we can add multiple action related to the same do action. So I will add another action and give it the same name as the above, but here the name of function should be different, otherwise it will perform the same function. If you give it the same function, my own action function, it will perform the, but we want to make it perform something else, my another function. Here priority again I give it 10, save, and here I create function my another function and echo something have a good day. Simple. Now I don't need to do action again, it will automatically do the same thing and display both hello world and have a good day on the single post here. You see, on the same line they are displaying. So I can put it by adding a p tag here, p tag here, p tag here, p tag here, and then I will refresh and you see hello, have a good day. So now here comes the priority role. They have same priority. So what if I do 10 to this and I give 5 to this and save it and run it again. You see, the have a good day moves up and hello world moves down. This is just because of the priority changing. So if I make it 5 again and both have same priority now, so they will display in the order as they are in the order add action here. So this is the function of priority. We have discussed about add action and do action. So now let's talk about remove action. What remove action will do, that whatever you have added or whatever theme author or plugin author have added using add action, you can remove that action by using remove action and providing it for three parameters: the name of the tag which you want to perform the remove action. For this example, my own action. So I will add here my own action. Then you need to provide the function. Like there are two functions. So which one you want to remove? So suppose I want to remove this one. So just copy this function and paste it here. And at the end, the priority, whatever priority this function have, you have to put the same priority. So it's a 5. I will make it 5. Then I save it and reload the page, and this one will be gone. You see, have a good day is gone. This is how you use action hooks. I am not going to explain built-in action and filter hooks, because in these tutorials I'm going to customize WooCommerce. So we will be playing with the action hooks and filters of WooCommerce, not the WordPress itself or theme or any theme. I hope you understand what are the action hooks. In the next video tutorial, I will be discussing about filters and filter hooks. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. I hope you liked it.